Welcome back to StrategyQuant, which you successfully installed and set up in the last lesson, and you started building strategies for gold using the start button in the custom project. You must have noticed that there are several sequential tasks before StrategyQuant generates the resulting strategies. And that's exactly what we are going to look at today. I will explain the individual steps in general terms today and focus in detail on the first task, which is the initial strategy building. I will show you how to set up the basic build and what options you actually have. Now, you may be wondering what there is to explain if you just click the start button. And how is it actually possible to differentiate your robots from others so that you can succeed in the market with them? You know, the thing is that StrategyQuant is very comprehensive, and I will explain to you step by step how to set up the whole process, and finally, how to create a comprehensive functional portfolio of robots that will trade just for you. However, many of you are seeing StrategyQuant for the very first time. That's why I will explain the basics first, because without that, it just wouldn't work. In fact, the goal of this course is to give you the know-how to become a fully independent and knowledgeable trader, not a manual on how to press some green button. So let's start with the first task, build strategies. Build is, shall we say, a hatchery of strategies. In this step, StrategyQuant, with the help of genetics and AI, builds a large number of robots based on some basic conditions. In this step, the strategies are not filtered in any way, which means that there are a lot of unsuitable and consequently unworkable or unusable strategies among them. It is the other tasks that are used to get the best possible strategies. For example, task 2 and 3, OOS or out of sample tests, where strategies are tested on a time range that was not included in the initial build. Like, for example, on data for the last year. Strategies that pass the OOS1 go on to be tested by the OOS2 test. Again, strategies that pass the OOS2 continue to the next task, M30 and then H4, which is testing on different timeframes. This is because we are initially building strategies for the 1 hour time frame, but we want our strategies to at least somehow work on different timeframes. The surviving strategies are then tested on slippage. This test simulates how a strategy would perform if it were to execute a trade under like degraded conditions, for example, slightly later than planned. Another test that strategies must pass is, simply put, a parameter change, where we change the parameter values of the strategies in some way. And after all these tests, we only get quality strategies, which we can then start testing on a demo account with virtual money. That was a general description of how this process works. Now let's take a look at build. As I mentioned, this is the place, or rather part of the process, where StrategyQuant generates a large number of strategies. But in order to generate anything at all, it needs to know the basic input values. It needs to know what to actually build. First and foremost, it needs to know what platform we are building for. In our case, the engine is MetaTrader 5. Next, for what symbol? For us, it's gold, so XAUUSD. And the aforementioned time frame. Next is the date range. And I will add that all the data is already included in StrategyQuant by default, so you don't need to download anything externally. More of the information we give to StrategyQuant is also in the trading options tab. For example, like exit on Friday. That is, whether we want the strategy to trade over the weekend or not. In the Building Blocks tab, we select various conditions for building, signals, indicators, order types, exit types, and so on. And an integral part of this is money management. So, how big we want the positions we open to be. With all these options, we set what robots StrategyQuant should generate for us. In the next lesson, I will explain the other tasks in more detail, especially the so-called robustness test, like mentioned out of sample, the test on different time frame or slippage. These are the tests that help us get the best strategies. And that's all for today. If you don't currently have the build of this project running, be sure to turn it on and let StrategyQuant build 1,000 strategies that we are going to work with further. Take a next step to your goal of building stable and profitable portfolio. I look forward to seeing you on the next video, and don't forget to follow our channel so you don't miss the following videos.